That became impossible because she wouldn't do that. She wouldn't have anything to do with your program or your team.
Well, I'm a nice guy.
Yeah, you are.
Well, I am, as it happens. Go on.
So, this is what we were dealing with, but it was a case of put the station first. And Sonia has considerable talents as a presenter. And so, shut your mouth, get on with it. But there comes a point when people don't get their way and threaten to walk out, and then threaten to walk out again, that it starts to grate and it starts to impact upon what we're trying to do. But anyway, what actually happened and what brought this about was that we had that telethon that last Friday to try to raise some money to keep us going beyond where we will unless something changes. And you went the first 3 hours. And it was very entertaining. We had the bands and all that. And then the second 3 hours came on. And it wasn't telethon material with Sonia. It was the Sonia Poulton show, which is not what the program was about, really. So eventually, it got very one-pacey with just people talking around the table. And the senior producer, Sean, went in the gallery and said, look, there's a film coming up later. Can we move the film further forward to break up all this chat? What followed was a diatribe by Sonia to Sean, which a mainstream television employee of many, many decades said that they had never seen a presenter talk to a station manager or a senior producer like that in her entire career. So we couldn't have that. We had to sort this out. So it was made clear after the program, because she got away, because what she did in the diatribe was say, if anything changes, I'm walking out now. And we're in the middle of a 6-hour live show trying to raise money to stay alive. So, okay, we'll do it your way. So it was made clear afterwards that that was absolutely unacceptable. And we weren't having it, basically. Up to this point, and we're talking last Friday, Sonia Poulton had never raised the issue at any point with us in the entire time she's had any association with us about the impropriety with relation to spending funds. And personally, I have nothing to do with the money. I'm an employee. I have no access to any of it because I'm not a director.
You're a volunteer.
Yeah. The people that look after the finances are accountants and bookkeepers and the head of production, Liz Roberts, who I'll come to in a second, who ironically has been highly praised by Sonia Poulton. And sure. And so we're in a situation where we can't let this go on because you can't keep threatening to walk out. And walk out in the middle of a live telethon when you're trying to keep the station alive. So up to this point, like I say, there was no mention of anything to do with money. And she's been here for all these weeks. It took 12 hours, something like that, after that incident, for her to start sending emails out complaining about how money was spent. Not that she knows. And so we had two things then. On the Monday, we arranged to that she would talk with us. And there were two subjects. One, her behavior during the telethon. And two, what she was now claiming out of nowhere about the use of money. So she was allowed to speak first and started to talk about this shouldn't have been spent, that shouldn't have been spent, or whatever. It was very, very vague, no detail. So she was asked, give us the detail. Give us the detail of what you're claiming. There was no detail, because there was no detail to give. And at this point, when it was pointed out that her behavior was not acceptable, then she stormed out and left. And since that time, she has been doing everything she can to damage this station and everything that we stand for as monumentally as she can, by making, again, allegations with no detail, all innuendo, and when she's asked to provide detail, none's forthcoming, because there is none. What I find extraordinary is that someone can see what these people, mostly volunteers, have been doing and what they've created and what they've given. How she can go on video so many times that people have seen on the station saying, the people's voice, fantastic, we must have it, it's so vital and it's wonderful and everything's great. How at the end of the telethon she could talk about, only last Friday, this is fantastic, I can't, it's wonderful TPV and I can't, all these wonderful people and I can't see myself going back to mainstream and all that. And then the very next morning starts the allegations, which are now going all over the social networks that are connected to her. So Sonia, you say that people need a voice. You say that they must have an alternative to hear what's really going on in the world. You say that people suffering from austerity and disabled people in terrible straits, you're saying that they must be given a voice. We've been doing that. And now, out of sheer spite and resentment, she's trying to destroy it. Now, why the allegations about money? Well, there's been two other people who stayed a very short time. I think one guy's called Ian Kelly, another guy's called Mark Welsh, Scottish bloke, who started slagging us off when they left. And they were in and out in no time. And why money? Why did they go for the money? And this is why. Because the idea is to, out of spite and vindictiveness, damage the people's voice and our ability to function as fundamentally as they can. Now, then you ask the question, if you're trying to do that, what would damage them most? Well, we are a television station funded by the public. So the thing that would damage us most in their minds is they're taking the money, they're misusing the money. And that's what it's about. And that's what they go for. So here we are in the middle of a massive crash and trying to keep this station going. And we've had to now divert people with much better things to do to get the figures together.